has been a lot of buzz around TVN's latest drama, Mr. Sunshine, and with good reason. It's the third collaboration between writer Kim Yoon-suk and director Lee Young-bok, the writer-director combination behind hit K-dramas Goblin and Descendants of the Sun. Mr. Sunshine premiered its first two episodes over the weekend, but did it live up to the hype? Read on to find out. See also, Mr. Sunshine sets new record with first episode viewership ratings. Warning, this article contains minor spoilers for episodes 1 and 2 of Mr. Sunshine. Soompi. Display. News. English. 300x250. BTF Soompi. Mobile. English. 300x250. ATF visually, at least Mr. Sunshine went above and beyond all expectations, and the spectacular, sweeping camera shots of gorgeous scenery make the drama a treat to watch. After all, it's easy to fall in love with a drama that looks like this, and this, and also all of this, but it takes more than pure aesthetics to keep us invested in a drama, and Mr. Sunshine would do well to make sure it doesn't overemphasize the cinematography at the expense of its plot. The premiere episodes spend a lot of time panning over scenes of the ocean, a montages of characters running through forests and fields, and while we definitely aren't complaining about the beautiful scenery, the amount of time dedicated to it does make Mr. Sunshine feel rather slow-paced at times. This effect is magnified by the fact that, when it does focus on its characters, the drama tends towards the melodramatic. Expect a lot of tears and brooding from the first episodes. Pete's Bowler. The premiere episodes sometimes feel contrived in this way, as if trying to force us to care about characters before we actually know enough about them to care. A tragic scene of a mother sacrificing her life for her child should be heartbreaking and moving, but when it is long and drawn out and comes 10 minutes into the first episode, it feels slightly awkward. But this is a relatively minor complaint compared to the overarching plot of Mr. Sunshine, which is extremely enticing. Set at the turn of the 20th century, the drama is enormous in scale. It crosses oceans and bridges time periods, bringing the traditional Joseon dynasty into contact with the rapidly modernizing West. This backdrop of change and upheaval sets the perfect stage for the action and romance of the story. Korean drama feels. The first episode follows main character Choi Yoo-jin, the son of two Joseon servants, through his tragic childhood and his escape to the US. Child actor Kim Kang-hoon plays young Yoo-jin, carrying the show for much of the first episode, which is no small feat in a drama of such epic proportions, but Kim does a phenomenal job, showcasing an impressive range of emotions that makes it easy to become invested in his story. Pete's Bowler. In America, Yoo-jin calls himself Eugene, growing up to become an officer in the Marines. Adult Eugene, Lee Byung-hun, is, so far, not nearly as charismatic as his childhood self. Lee Byung-hun spends a lot of time gazing forlornly into space while reminiscing about his tragic past. To be fair, there is a lot for Eugene to be forlorn about, but it's going to take more than Lee Byung-hun's silent brooding for adult Eugene to become a character that we care deeply about. Female-led Go Eshin, Kim Tae-ri, has a similarly unhappy past. Her parents, independence fighters, die at the hands of pro-Japanese sympathizers shortly after she is born. Thankfully, before this happens, Mr. Sunshine takes the opportunity to throw in a little treat for all Descendants of the Sun fans out there, in the form of cameos by Kim Ji-won and Jin Gu as Eshin's parents. Pete's Bowler. These two won't be the only familiar faces to Descendants and Goblin fans. David Lee McInnes, top left below, and Jo Woo Jin, top right below, are also members of the supporting cast of Mr. Sunshine. Cameos galore. In the absence of her mother and father, Eshin grows up as a noblewoman in her grandfather's household. But she proves to be every bit as rebellious as her parents, showing an unladylike interest in the political happenings of Joseon and a determination to fight for her country. And herein lies one of the greatest strengths of Mr. Sunshine. Thus far, its female characters are total badasses. Eshin rejects her grandfather's order that she forget about her country's politics and fill her time with embroidery instead, until he gives in and decides that if she's going to stir up trouble, she might as well learn to defend herself. Which she does quite well. Binge the K-drama. Equally as bold and intriguing is hotel owner Koo Do-hina, Kim Min-young, who makes only a brief